Hello everybody, I'm Errichto and I will show you a coding interview problem, set matrix zeros that you can find on the platform LeetCode. And the link is in the description below. In this problem, we are given a rectangular matrix, and if an element is zero, we should set its entire row and column to zero. And while this problem wouldn't be so hard, the tricky thing is that we should do it in place, what means we can use no extra memory. Well, in fact, we can use only constant extra memory. So we should modify the given matrix, but only we can use single extra variables instead of arrays. And let's take a look at example here. We're given some matrix. And for every zero, it changes all the numbers in its row and in its column to zeros. So, for example, this 2 would be changed because it's in the same row as some 0, but this 3 wouldn't be changed. So if we mark the first zeros, the initial zeros as red, then every red 0 changes the numbers in its row and column. But let's remember that the new zeros don't change extra values in the new row or column. Because if they did, we would get the matrix containing of all zeros, even if only one zero would exist in the initial matrix, because it would change its row and column to zeros, and they would change other cells again. So the initial zeros are different from new ones. And let's see some implementation, some solution for this problem that doesn't work in doesn't work in constant memory. It uses linear memory. So we're given some matrix. What we can do is for every column, we can check if it contains a zero. So this first column does, third one as well. So here it would be, yeah, true, it contains zero, it contains. And here it would be false, false, false. So it's an array of Boolean values, true, false, false. And the same for rows. So for every row, check in linear time for this row whether it contains a zero. So this one doesn't. Then once we do that, we can iterate over the matrix again. And if for a given cell, if its row or column are marked as true, that they contain a zero, then we change it to zero. So the time complexity is the size of the matrix, because we just iterate over the matrix twice or maybe three times, and the memory consumption is height plus width, which we want to improve. But let's see the implementation of that. So we have height and width of matrix, and we create Boolean arrays to mark whether some row contains a zero and whether some column contains a zero. We iterate over matrix once. So for every cell, if this cell is zero, then we mark corresponding row and column as true. And then we have the second iteration over the whole matrix. And now for every cell, if row with this cell is set as true, as containing zero, or column the same, then we set this value here as zero. So now what we want to do is improve the memory complexity. So what you might think to do, but it's incorrect, is to just, for example, for every new zero, just mark all the numbers here as zeros and the same for row, and then move on. Well, we said at the beginning why it's incorrect, because new cells containing zeros are not the same as initial zeros. If for this zero you mark here, you say that zero is here, then when you move to the next row, you would mark all numbers here as zeros because there is a zero here. So an idea you might have is to mark this new zero as some fake number, for example, minus one. And let's say that minus one means a new zero, so it doesn't propagate. But it isn't correct because the statement doesn't say what is the what are boundaries for numbers. Possibly they possibly in the input there could be all possible numbers that fit in the int type. So you can't assume that, for example, you only have non-negative numbers here and minus one wouldn't appear. So this wouldn't be okay. Even though maybe when you submit a solution here, you would get accepted because tests don't contain that value, but it wouldn't be a correct solution when you have a coding interview. So let's think about a different solution. So when we go through a matrix row by row, in fact, we don't have to compute this array for every row in advance. When we are at the first row, we can just check in linear time whether it contains a zero. We can assign a Boolean value for that, so just Boolean value whether there is zero in this row instead of the whole array. So yeah, in this case, we have true here, so this is true. But right now, we don't need the next values for the next rows, for the following rows. And now we mark every cell here as zero, and we move on. And we will never anymore need this value. What we need in advance is our values for columns, because when we are in the second row, for example, so we move here, we know that there is no zero in this row, so the Boolean value we have as false. And we should mark some cells here as zeros. And for that, we need the array for columns. And what we'll do is, once we'll create an array for columns, whether every column contains a zero, but then we move row by row, and we just create a single variable for whether there's a zero here. So let's modify our implementation. Previously, we had an array for rows and an array for columns. Now we only want to leave the array for columns. And now what we do? We remove the array for rows. So as the preprocessing, we only know whether every column contains a zero. And now in the second run, for every row, let's create a single variable contains zero. So whether a row contains zero, we iterate over over cells in this row. If it's a zero, contains zero, we mark as true. We could put a break here, but it doesn't affect the complexity, so whatever. And now, once again, we iterate over cells in this row. And if this column contains a zero, or this time just this single variable is set to true, then we set the cell as zero. Let's run our code to make sure it passes the example. It does. And now the memory complexity we have is, instead of height plus width, it's just O of height. O of width. Because we create this array of size equal to width of the matrix. And now we should think how to improve that to the constant memory. Well, when we move through some cells already, it would be nice to use values in those cells to store our extra array, because this is the only place where we can store those values. So how to do it? Well, if we don't have to restore the first row, for example, then it's a perfect place to store the array. True, false, true, false, false. So maybe we here would say, so this is what we can do if we don't care at the end about the values in this first row. So here, for example, we would change this first value to zero. So this would be zero because this column contains a zero. Well, the same here, it just stays. And then the remaining part, so the remaining matrix, everything except for the first row, we can do in constant memory. Because for every new row, we create our variable for whether this row contains a zero. And then we take a look at the first row to see if somewhere is some cell contains a zero, because it means this column contains zero. But the bad thing is that the first row will not be marked correctly. So what is the only issue here? Well, in this case, if we remove this one and put a zero here, then at the end we should still mark all this row as zeros. But otherwise, so if, for example, instead of zero we had here, let's say, a seven, then let's see what happens. So in our the first step in our solution would be to, in the first row, to mark some cells as zeros. So then a 7 would be changed to 0. Here 1 would be changed to 0. But for the whole row, we would know the value false, because initially the row didn't contain a 0. And when we process the rest of the matrix, everything is fine. We don't have to do anything anymore. So we'll use the first row to contain the information where columns should be set as zeros. And it doesn't hurt us to remove those values, so to lose value 1 and to lose 7, to change them to zeros, because at the end there will be zeros. In the column where there is zero, every cell will be zero indeed. So we don't need a 7. The only thing we might lose, is the fact whether the first row, as here, if this is 7 here, it should stay with some numbers non-zero, or, as in this case, if there is a 0 here at initially, then we remember this true, and at the end we mark the whole row as zeros. So we should just, as an extra variable, at the beginning remember this value. And let's now move to the implementation to understand everything better. So here we'll create a variable whether first row should be set to 0. We iterate over cells in this first row. If matrix first row called is 0, then first row 0 we mark as true. Now we can remove the array for columns. And instead of that, we here in the first run through the matrix, instead of saying that the column should contain 0, we just say that the cell, corresponding cell in the first row, is set to 0. So here it was this case. There was a 0 here, so we mark in the same column, we mark a cell in the first row as 0. Matrix in the first row is 0. And this denotes the whole column is filled with zeros, should be filled with zeros. Okay, what now? We iterate through the whole matrix to now fill everything. So we iterate over rows. Still, we check, but this time let's start from the second row, because we don't want to affect now the first row, because it contains some values we need. So at the beginning, we don't want to here set everything to 0 immediately, because then we would lose our array for columns. Okay, we iterate starting from the second row. Well, row number 1 if you count from 0. And again, you check if this row contains 0, just as before. And now, when you want to mark new cells as zeros, instead of checking the array for columns, we just check if matrix in the first row call is 0. Okay? And the very last thing to do is to fill the first row with zeros. So if our variable first row 0, so if first row 0, then fill the first row with zeros. And that's it. Let's run code. Here you can see that we don't use arrays anymore at all. We only use a single variable here, and also like height and width. And let's submit our solution. So it will be tested on all the tests. And it's accepted. So this is how you solve set matrix zeros in constant memory. So try to implement this solution yourself and to check to check the correctness by submitting, but also at the end go through your code, try to read it again and make sure you don't use any errors, because then possibly you would get accepted, but the whole difficulty here is to make it in constant memory. Thank you for watching. If you want more videos like this, please like this video and subscribe to the channel. Bye bye.